Greetings, everybody, and welcome to the first graduation for Wish Academy. I am honored to open these graduation ceremonies. My name is Dr. Danelle Fisher, and I am the president of the Wish Board of Directors. I'm also a pediatrician and have practiced in the Westchester area for 20 years. When Wish started as a new elementary school across the street from my office, many of my patients started attending the school. The families were so excited about Wish and explained to me what a special place it was. I became enamored of the school and its mission and heartily shared their enthusiasm. Here we are, 11 years later, graduating our first high school class. What a ride it has been. Wish is a unique place where everyone can be themselves and everyone is celebrated. Tonight, we rejoice in sending our seniors out into the world to be adults and do great things. They have paved the way for all future Wish Academy students and set the bar high for years to come. On behalf of the Wish Board, I would like to recognize some people without whom we would not be here tonight. Is there one person who does not know and love Dr. Shauna Draxton? As our director of schools, she is our fearless leader and our biggest cheerleader. She works tirelessly to make Wish the best school it can be. Dr. Draxton, we salute you as we congratulate the students today. And how about our incredible principal, Kelly Mole? She came back to the U.S. from England with big dreams of helping get Wish Academy off the ground. And look at her now, principal extraordinaire. Can we get a huge round of applause for our faculty and staff? The dedication and caring from our teachers, especially in this past pandemic year, is unparalleled. We are so grateful to you all. Finally, I would like to take this moment to recognize all of the families who founded Wish. These families showed perseverance and dedication. They painted walls and murals on the first campus, and the second campus, come to think of it, held bake sales and fundraising events, and spent countless hours volunteering in and out of classrooms. Among them is an amazing family that is the perfect example of why Wish is what it is. Years ago, Eric and Ivy Steinberg were searching for the perfect school for their son, an inclusive school. Wish was just that school. After elementary school, when Jack was getting ready for middle school, the Steinbergs were there to help establish Wish Middle. When Jack was getting ready for high school, the Steinbergs held weekly meetings in their home for 1 year to help develop Wish Academy. And they were joined by many of the parents here in this audience. Tonight, as we honor our inaugural graduating class with Jack and all of our amazing scholars, we tip our hats to the Steinbergs for a job well done. To Wish Academy's inaugural graduating class, the class of 2021, you did it! We are thrilled to cheer you on as you close this chapter of your life and go on to what is next. Congratulations and best wishes for you all.
Please place your hand over your heart and rise for the anthem, for the national anthem.
Whose stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets' red glare, the bombs bursting. Still there, oh, say, does that star-spangled banner yet wave for the land of the free?
Good afternoon, class of 2021. Welcome, parents, caregivers, faculty, staff, grandparents, community members, board members, and everyone here celebrating our inaugural class of Wish Academy. To every graduate, we are so proud of you. Thank you for standing by Wish Academy as we work to build a school grounded in the values close to our hearts. You, our students, families, faculty, and board members, were the leaders. You sitting right here were the risk takers, and you were the light. You embodied the spirit of Amanda Gorman's words, the Presidential Poet Laureate. You reminded us, there is always light, if only we're brave enough to see it, if only were brave enough to be it. You stood by Wish Academy when there were so many unknowns, and you were brave as we forged ahead to ensure our social justice through inclusivity efforts at our community school could be extended to a new generation of high school students. Thank you for being part of Wish Academy when things were going well, such as winning sports teams, innovative exhibitions and performances, college acceptances, prom,
and exciting new classes. And thanks for believing in Wish Academy when things were developing. It is never easy to build something new. And when you do, you make a prototype. Share it, use it, and then refine it. Wish Academy has evolved over the last few years with your guidance. And with every collaborative decision and new addition, the iterations get better. Thank you. So as the TK through 12th grade executive director, I get to share a story from way back when some of you were with us at Wish Elementary School in the second grade. Truly, those of you who have been with us in second grade have gone the long haul. I still remember our teeny tiny school located at the corner of Manchester and La Tijera. And as your principal at that time, I learned quickly how to balance student voice. For folks who were not with us back then, let me share a little story. Since this was our first group of students, we asked them to vote on a mascot. All the classes put forth names, and the range was expansive. There was everything from the Wish Hamsters to the Wish Fish. I wanted to have the Wish Starfish. I thought it would be fun, and we could get the kids' attention by saying, "Show me your Wish Starfish," and I would imagine all the kids holding out their hands and making a starfish face. The second grade class, some of who are here with us today, started a different campaign and had other ideas. They encouraged other students to write in a unique mascot, one that represented a common insect that they saw in the tiny rented church space. Does anybody remember what it was? That's right. Today, we could be cheering Go Wish Cockroaches. The second graders, many of whom are in this graduating class, wanted us to be the Wish Cockroaches, and they convinced so many of their peers to write that in and take the vote. And when the voting was done, a parent leader read off the winner, and I was mortified and cried to my old principal, "What are we going to do? We'll be the laughingstock of Westchester. We will be the Wish Cockroaches, and everyone will make fun of us." She laughed and said, "Have a runoff and talk to the kids about the meaning of their mascot and the intent and what it could be, and talk to them about what it will look like on their baseball jerseys 10 years from now." So we did do a runoff, and the students voted for the Wishwise Wizards because it was a Harry Potter craze at the time. And that's why you'll see on some of our old logos, the owl has a wizard hat. But with some more discussion, we moved to the Wishwise Owls, and that's why the wizard hat in our earliest, that's why the Wish Owl in our earliest drawings has a wizard hat. So thanks to these silly students sitting next to you, we were almost the Wish Cockroaches, and thankfully because of their critical thinking, we are not. And just so you know, owls eat cockroaches, so I think you made an excellent choice. You've continued to make impactful decisions and many new friends as the years went on. Middle school was an important time to make connections and friendships. During this time, we lost one of our close classmates, a friend to many of you sitting here. I mentioned Dejan as we celebrate today because his life was full of love, enthusiasm, and a zest for adventure. I know, like me, many of you keep him in your hearts and think about him often. For folks who didn't know Dejan, I know there are other people who were part of your journey throughout your life towards this day. I hope you feel their love today, their pride in your accomplishments, and you let them lift you up and help you move on to your next adventure. Each of them had a role in getting you to this celebration, and we are grateful for the gifts each gave us so that we could be here. Before I conclude, I'd like to leave you with a little advice. Be like nature. Let your truth prevail in all you do, and dare to be the light. Your everlasting and essential legacy will be that you pave the way for others here at Wish Academy, and paving the way is never easy. Walking on a smooth pathway that is shiny and beautiful is always easier. As Robert Frost said, two roads diverged in the wood, and I took the one less traveled by. And that has made all the difference. When you chose Wish Academy, you bravely chose a road that hadn't been built. I hope it made a difference for you as a human being. And I know it has made a difference for those that follow. I'm so proud to share with the new Wish families about all the ways you have lit the path for others. From designing pathway courses to creating the Honor Society, from ensuring every single person has a seat at the table. to inviting your teachers to home games to cheer you on, you have created something very special. Remember to come back and let us know how you are doing. We are and will always be your biggest fans. We can't wait to see the many ways you influence the world and take on the adventures before you. Congratulations and enjoy these next steps. And without further ado, I have the privilege of welcoming the phenomenal leader who has led the way for the faculty, staff, and each of you sitting here from day one. Ms. Moll set out to know each and every one of you, to communicate high standards of excellence, and to ensure that you were challenged, elevated, and thrust out into the world, given the very best guidance, support from the faculty and staff. She is a force that ignites a fire in each of us, inspiring us to reach higher and do better. Please help me welcome the amazing and fantastic principal of Wish Academy, Ms. Kelly Moll.
Thank you, Dr. Drexton. I want to start by saying that my profession is an excellent one. I'm given so many gifts being in education: the gift of community, the gift of relationships, the gift of being able to accomplish goals, aspirations, dreams with a team, dreams on a team, dreams for a team. And as a principal, I get to see this every day. I don't really get to see you because this microphone's in front of me, so I hope you can see me. I have so much to share with you in this last hour of our time together, and I will do as much as I can in the 5 minutes I have to highlight, focus, and recall the amazing accomplishments and achievements you have brought to the first graduation and graduating class of Wish Academy High School. Also, as a principal, it is my job to balance leadership, academic success, family relationships, teacher collaboration, student excellence, our reputation, our belief in each other, and most importantly, the hopes and dreams of our students, and the reality and the belief that they can make amazing things happen when given the opportunity. It is also my job to remain supportive, impartial, reflective, calm, and provide a safe and stable environment for all who join us here at Wish Academy. I remember my conversations with each and every one of you. I remember them well, and there's one in particular that has stayed with me throughout the years. And while this young man was in my office, he thanked me for helping him navigate a situation. And as he left, he said, "You know, you're a pretty good principal, I think." I said, "Thank you. Believe it or not, there are emotions here. I have them." He said, "Wait, I don't understand. You only have one emotion." And I assured him that I have more than that, and that one day he would believe this, and hopefully today is that day. Emotion number one, happiness. Oh, how I have absolutely missed you all. I've missed being with you throughout the school year, and it fills my heart with joy to be with you all here again today. Seeing your faces, your smiles, seeing your masks, and hearing your voices all together creates the connection again that we have been so much longing for. We are so incredibly fortunate to be able to gather together here today to share this happiness, and it spreads across our stage, our seats, and into the bleachers. Emotion number two, pride. I want to show each and every one of you off to the world. I want to wave my arms and yell, "Look over here, see this beautiful person, this amazing student, teacher, parent, family, board member, athlete, communicator, leader, creator, inventor. Look at these amazing change makers. How did I get so lucky to be a part of this and to be included in the lives of everyone sitting in front of me and the people around that have supported them along the way?" Emotion number three. There are only four, by the way. Emotion number three, bittersweetness. With the happiness and the pride, I admit this is bittersweet, and I do feel sadness in my heart. I made it. Knowing that I will not see you every day, that our conversations will no longer take place, the line of students waiting to get in my office to present an idea, a proposal, or a dream to make a growing school the best place possible will change. But change is something we do not escape in education or in life, and I look forward to the example that you have provided to ensure students continue to feel confident, safe, and willing to speak to administration about their dreams. Without them, Wish Academy would not thrive. It is only with you that we have become a space, a place, and a school to educate others on the importance of caring and belonging, the impact of collaboration and teamwork, and that with love, compassion, and honesty, anything is possible. Emotion number four, hope. The last one I will share with you is hope. I have so much of it. If I could give a little piece to each and every one of you in a little box to bring it with you after you leave this field tonight, I would. I would wrap it in the most beautiful paper and a gorgeous bow to remind you it is the most valuable gift you can hold in your hands and in your heart. I hope you leave this field today with the understanding, the true understanding, that you are smart, beautiful, powerful, and you have made a positive impact at our school. I hope that you know your teachers care for you so much, and they are people that will be for you, there for you always, if only you take the time to reach out to them as you grow. Life will not always be easy. You won't always get what you want, and you will experience difficulties as you venture out into the world around you. But you will grow from these. You will grow from these experiences. You will learn to navigate your way and find that others are doing the same. You will experience love and joy, success, triumph, and happiness. And remember, as Thomas Edison said, opportunity is dressed in overalls, and it does look like work. And please remember that keeping hope will guide you there. I hope you keep in touch. I hope you reach out to us and let us know where you are and how you're doing. And I hope you remember that Wish is a place that will forever hold you dear, and that you find happiness in all that you do. These emotions that I have are a secret. Please don't tell anyone that I'm a real person. I have to keep this principal act up for quite a few years longer. Congratulations, class of 2021. I am so proud to be part of this memory, and I am honored that I have been able to be a part of your lives. Thank you so much. I now have the privilege and honor to welcome our fabulous guest of honor here, Superintendent Tony Thurn.
Thank you, Principal Mole. Do you all call her the Mole? We had a chance to have a little chat before today, and she said that y'all call her the Mole because she knows how to slip into places just like a mole. So somebody in the back is nodding their head yes. She's like, mm-hmm. My name is Tony Thurman. I have the honor of serving as California's State Superintendent of Public Instruction. I have the honor of serving you in Sacramento and in our state, and representing more than 10,000 schools in our state. And admittedly, I didn't do anything to get you where you are here today. You did it, and your families did it, and your educators who are here put that all together. So let's start with a round of applause for the class of 2021 and their supporters here at Wish. I'm certain somebody's saying, he just said he didn't do anything. Why is he up here on the stage? I'm grateful for this opportunity to bring you greetings from the California Department of Education. I'm grateful for the opportunity to stand with you and to be part of the team that acknowledges you as the first graduating class for Wish. And as I thought about what I might say today, I kept trying to think about what was I thinking when I was sitting where you are. It's too long ago for me, I can't remember. But I'm sure it was something like this: what do I do next? And please don't let this speaker speak for too long. And so and this is my first graduation in the earshot of airplanes. And I promise you that you all are experiencing a first that I hope you'll never have to experience again. That you're experiencing graduation coming out of a COVID-19 pandemic. a life-changing event that has happened only once before, almost 100 years ago. And I promise you that what we have experienced is probably one of the toughest experiences that we will have in our lifetime. But you have persevered. You have overcome obstacles and adversity. And remember what you see here today. As you look at each other wearing face masks, having to be socially distanced, thinking about even the toughest things that have happened, the loss of loved ones, and all the disruptions that COVID-19 has brought, the killing of George Floyd, the spike in hate against the Asian American Pacific Islander community, watching undocumented children and watching unaccompanied minors be mistreated, and watching hate grow in our nation at a time when we should be finding ways to come together. I encourage you, while it was hard, to not forget it, and to know that in spite of all of it, you persevere. You've overcome adversity. And so what that means is that whatever you choose to do going forward, don't let anyone tell you that you cannot, because today is proof that yes, you can. I've not walked in your shoes, so I won't pretend to know what this year has been like for you. My graduations were not under COVID conditions. But I've lived a few years and I've experienced a little bit of adversity. And I won't get into all the details, but as someone who is a California native, standing before you is the descendant of slaves and the descendant of immigrants from places like Panama and Jamaica and Detroit, Michigan, by way of Mississippi. My grandparents came to this country with just a dream, a wish that they could create better for their family. My grandmother cleaned houses and raised 7 kids and dreamed that her children would get an education. Nobody in my family ever had the chance to run for office. And my family also experienced obstacles and adversity. Sadly, as a young person, I lost my mother to cancer, my only parent. My father was a soldier who served in Vietnam, who never came home from the Vietnam War, because what he would tell me when I finally met him is that the trauma that he experienced in war was too difficult for him to return to his family. So I found my father on the internet for the first time as a grown man, after I'd already gone through my struggles as a younger man, trying to figure out who I was gonna be as a man, and as a father, and as a sibling, and as a son. And so I say to you that don't let these experiences that you've encountered in the pandemic stop you from achieving your dream. Because before you is someone who's also experienced obstacles, growing up on the free lunch program, growing up on public assistance. And my family, we ate so much government cheese, I thought that the letters USDA was a brand name. I know only the parents get it, right? Because when we were kids, because we didn't always have enough food to eat, someone would deliver a box of cheese. Can you believe that? A big old box of cheese wrapped in this thick plastic that if you got through it, it was the best grilled cheese or quesadilla you ever had. Because we were hungry, but we never went without. And so in my life, I had a lot of great public programs in my life. The most important public program in my life was a chance to get an education. And my educators said to me, your life will be different than it started. And I believed them. And they said, if you believe in the promise of education, the promise of education will deliver and return to you whatever it is that you want to be. And I promise you the same is true for you. Wherever it is that you want to go in life, whatever it is that you want, if it's college, whatever your plan is for post-secondary education, to get a good job, care for your family, a car, clothes. I got 2 teen daughters, so trust me, they slip me the list all the time. Whatever it is that you dream about, you can achieve. As you do, just as you did today. Today we celebrate you. But don't think for a second that the journey is over. It's beginning. And we want you to continue to strive and to dream for all the things that you want to achieve. And everyone around you, our responsibility is to have your back and to support you in helping you to get to that next thing that you want to do. So I stand before you and I say congratulations, felicidades, you have arrived. A cheer to your families, to your generations, to your educators, your administrators who've cared for you. You are our future, and you represent a wish that I have for all of our 6 million students in this state, that they get a great education and go on to live a great life. I'm proud of you, I love you. Congratulations to the class of 2021.
That was amazing, very impressive. Thank you so much. Thank you for being here and joining us. Okay, I would like to ask Noah Shen to please come to the stage. Thank you.
If Max and Robert had tried just a little harder in school, I wouldn't have to write this speech. But we have just a few minutes as us students to express ourselves in front of everyone here. And if I learned anything from Ms. Shea's super condensed economics course, it's that scarcity is the main driver of something's value. So I guess I'm really lucky to be the one person to represent all of us. So this is what I want to say. And I'm sure you guys feel similarly. We spent a lot of time on Zoom the past year, more time than I want to spend for the rest of my life. And it's had its ups and downs, such as being able to pull a laptop from under the covers and join class, which I totally didn't do, but I could see how it could be a thing. However, I know that at least I have been in some pretty dark places over the pandemic, academically and socially, and all the elites. And it's been pretty hard for us to stay motivated. So being here today and graduating and listening to all the awards y'all got yesterday, I realized we're really amazing. You guys are really amazing. And we had an exceptional year, even disregarding the unique hardship that whatever power in charge lined up perfectly with what should have been an amazing senior year. And I'm being genuine, if that means anything to y'all. I also want to say, it's been hard for us students to stay motivated, but it must have been exponentially more difficult for the teachers and faculty. And not only staying motivated to teach their subjects in a difficult new environment, but also to drag us tooth and nail to the finish line is nothing short of superheroic. Dr. Branch filling in for while Principal Mole had her baby, dealing with many uncertainties of a COVID-infected school year. And then coming back and catching our sorry selves up for the AP calculus test, which we took yesterday. Miss S furiously helping us complete our college applications and apply for scholarships, making sure each and every one of us will move on successfully next year. Miss Shea and her wonderfully crafted economics course that fulfilled very, very last minute A through G requirements. Miss Landon, who worked for months and dealt with the ever-changing COVID policies to give us deeply treasured senior experiences, such as this event now, and grad night, and prom on a boat, which was ingenious, by the way, Miss Small. And all the AP teachers who didn't even know what tests we were preparing for until more than halfway through the school year, and still made sure that we got to the testing date as well prepared as they could force us to be. Yeah, yesterday was real rough, I'm not even gonna lie, and it was entirely my fault. And lastly, to my dear Coach Casey, who put up with 9 idiots and our dreadfully toxic masculinity and masculine energy, and much, much more to give us a sports season and to give me my life and my passion back. And let's not forget that if it weren't, And let's not forget that if it weren't for Dr. Draxton and countless other parents and workers that for the last 13 years and more, and if it weren't for Miss Mole and her firm leadership as a founding principal, we wouldn't be graduating as the very first graduating class of Wish Academy High School. From the class of 2021, to all of you, thank you. And there's so many more people that I can't touch on, and there's no way that this speech could capture the impact that my own parents had on me and how grateful I am to them. Thank you, Mama and Papa. I appreciate you so much. And because a 3-minute speech isn't nearly long enough to give the Wish faculty enough credit for working 24/7 for all of us the past year and the past 4 years, make sure that all y'all recognize them afterwards as well. And to end it off, to my peers, because this might very well be the last thing that I say to some of y'all, and the only thing that I can genuinely say, thank you so much for the past 4 years. I'm so lucky to have spent high school with the 60 or so of you here, and am a much better person, student, teammate, leader, and friend because of it. Thank you. And now I get the pleasure of introducing my two very good friends, our salutatorians, Max Mendelson and Robert Licari.
I'd just like to start by saying that I have one of the best sock collections in the state of California. This is undisputed. Moving on, I'd like to give a warm welcome to all of the parents and friends of our graduating class, as well as a special thank you to our state superintendent, Tony Thurmond. I thank you all for coming to celebrate with us. Next, I'd like to shout out some of my wonderful Wish faculty for helping me these past 4 years. First, I'd like to thank Dr. Branch. You took me, a student who was beginning to enjoy math, showed me its endless possibilities, and inspired me to pursue it. You are hands down the best upside-down writer I have ever seen. Next, I'd like to thank Ms. Shea. I may not be the most enthusiastic student when it comes to history, but you helped me enjoy learning about it. You showed me how to iron out the wrinkles of my public speaking and helped me slow down my speeches. I've gone from 75 miles an hour to 55 miles an hour. Miss Vaughn never fails to remind me that she has my mom on speed dial whenever I'm off task. She has expanded my vocabulary tenfold and taught me how to write a thesis. I am forever envious of your penmanship. Thank you so much. Jade, you have taught me so much about deaf culture, and you always made me practice every sign before each test. I appreciate all the times you checked in on me to ask if I was okay. It really helped me through this crazy year. Thank you. Mr. Mollenkamp, thank you for helping me find my love of science and engineering. Physics and engineering classes wouldn't have been the same without you. I will never forget your loud, booming voice. Coach Casey, I would like to thank you for mentoring me in volleyball and for all of the challenges you overcame teaching coaching our volleyball team. Unfortunately, my speech was proofed and edited this time, so I wasn't able to get away with any mischief. I do apologize for the mistimed piercings. I would like to give a special thanks to Miss S, who made sure I was getting into college no matter what. You were always here to support my high school journey, and I thank you. Thank you to Dr. Draxton and Ms. Mole for keeping the Wish Dream alive. We would not be here without you. You took so little and made it so much, and because of that, we have all had a life-changing experience. Thank you. And of course, last but not least, thank you to my parents for pushing me to do great things, no matter how much I complained. Class of 2021. For those of you who feel hesitant in any way to celebrate your accomplishments, don't forget we all graduated in spite of a pandemic. As daily obstacles were thrown in our way, we were able to persevere. We've never truly experienced all of the hardships of pandemic high school until you've sat through hundreds of Zoom meetings. As your class salutatorian, number one that is, I challenge all of us to pursue our dreams with passion and fervor and with gratitude for support of friends, family, and the Wish community. Hold on to the Wish mission and vision. Inclusivity means never leaving anyone behind. We can all succeed together. When we're all successful and fulfilled years from now, I trust we'll look back on these high school years as some of the best in our lives. I couldn't have survived a pandemic with a better community or a finer group of people. Thank you and congratulations to you all.
Anyone that knows me personally knows by now that I probably have earned a PhD in procrastination. And while I've definitely had my fair share of late nights before something was due, like that time Noah stayed at my house until 3 in the morning building a Coke bottle rocket that blew up and crashed into the floor, I can say in all sincerity that the greatest motivation for me when it came to staying on top of my work and finding the urge to succeed was my friends. And with that in mind, I would like to give my thanks to Noah and Max that have joined me up here on the stage, and I would like to say how happy I am for them to be here with me in these final moments of our high school career. Now, I've been going to Wish since the sixth grade, and many of my friends from back then have stuck with me until now into high school, such as Max. Now, back when I was still in middle school, I remember all of these kids were getting gold stars, and you get this gold star if you get a 4.0 GPA. And I remember vividly that everybody else, except for me, was taking pictures and had a gold star, and I was holding my little bronze star, and I remember thinking to myself, that wasn't enough for me. I had to become a part of that group. And it started out as a silly competition, but it ended up as a friendship, where we genuinely supported each other as they influenced my work ethic, especially in high school. The support that I had from my peers, and especially my parents, to push myself was the biggest influence on my life in recent years. And I will never be able to thank them enough for staying with me, even if I did make it a little bit difficult. So, to my parents, and each and all of you, I want to thank you for encouraging, motivating, and pushing me all the way to the stage tonight. This is the first of many big moments I will owe to you. And if I had to impart any advice for anyone starting their high school career, I would say, surround yourself with people that are going to push you to be your best self. Because as long as you have those to help you persevere, you will better appreciate the words of Confucius. It does not matter how slowly you go, so long as you do not stop. Which is exactly what this class of 2021 has done for me, and I thank you all from the bottom of my heart. Thank you. Please welcome Kiara Crawford.
To recite a poem for you guys. When things go wrong, as sometimes they will, when the road you're trudging seems all uphill, when the funds are low, but the debts are high, when you want to smile, but you have to sigh, when all care is down a bit, rest if you must, but don't you quit. Life is queer with its twists and turns, as many of us sometimes learns. And many a failure turns about when they might have won had they stuck it out. Don't give up, though the pace seems slow. You may succeed with another blow. Often the goal is nearer than it seems, so faint struggler has given up, when he might have won the victor's cup. And he learned too late when the night came down how close he was to the golden crown. Success is failure turned inside out. The silver tint of the clouds of doubt. And you'll never really know how close you are. It may be near, though it seems so far. So, stick it to the fight when your heart is hit. It's when the things seem worst that you must not quit. Thank you. I will be welcoming back to the stage the beautiful Dr. Draxton.
Excellent job. That was fantastic. Thank you. Thank you so much, students. We love hearing your voice. I get to welcome back up to right here before you, Dr. Darren Early. You all know Dr. Early. Please give him a warm welcome.
And if you don't know, now you know.
Hi, folks, how are you? Let's try this again. Wish Academy, class of 2021, how are you? That part, right there, right there. On behalf of the Loyola Marymount University President Timothy Snyder and the School of Education Dean Michelle Young, I am tremendously excited to be here with you this afternoon and share this special occasion. You see, I have a daughter who is also a senior in the class of 2021. She graduated just last Thursday, and I've witnessed firsthand the social, emotional, and mental perseverance of the class of 2021. And your adults. Shout outs to moms, dads, grands, uncles, aunties, mentors, coaches, teachers, and who is ever in your corner. Shout out, give them a hand, folks. We have all been on this wild ride called COVID-19, as the superintendent spoke to. Class of 2021, you have come through a global pandemic, racial discord in our nation, political turmoil, and many of you have dealt with personal and family tragedy. But today I want you to take a moment, literally look around you. No, I mean really look around you, at your classmates, at your teachers, your loved ones. You can look up in the stands. I mean, make eye contact, because we must realize, in the words of Drake, your senior year started at the bottom, now we're here. You started at the bottom, now the whole team's here. Give yourself a hand, folks. Your whole team is here. This is outstanding. This is outstanding. As the superintendent said earlier, we can't relate to that. In 1983, when I graduated from Westchester High School, I didn't have a senior year like yours. But you know what? I wasn't able to develop the perseverance that you have. Let me get back on script. As a transition into the rest of our time together, I want to share one of my favorite quotes from a renowned historian and professor, John Heinrich Clark. Dr. Clark states, "History is not everything, but it's a starting point. History is a clock that people use to tell their political and cultural time of day. It's a compass they use to find themselves on the map of human geography. History tells them where they are, but more importantly, it tells them what they must be. Today is historic, and you, as the first graduating class of Wish Academy, are history makers. Today's celebration can never be duplicated, primarily because there will be never again a first graduating class of Wish Academy. Other classes will follow. But the class of 2021 holds a unique spot in the history of this organization. You always will. And although history is not everything, as Dr. Clark said, it is a starting point. And today you have started something special. Today's celebration is also unique because this is the first and last time you will ever graduate from high school. Think about that. It is one of those events that won't happen again. So embrace this moment. This is the real moment. Because after today, your lives will be significantly different, and it will be different in real ways. Like, you know, some of you on the way home, your parents may ask you to give back those house keys. I'm just saying, reality is going to set in. Nevertheless, when you are an old man like me, the historical nature of this day, this time, and this space will serve as a compass that you use to find yourself on the map of human geography. In Dr. Clark's quote shared earlier, history tells you, the Wish Academy class of 2021, not only where you are, but more importantly, what you must be. To clarify this point and to put things into perspective, I'm gonna ask that you take a little ride with me and engage in some cognitive time travel back to the year 2003. Many of you don't remember much about 2003 because it was the year you were born, you had just been born, or were just about to be born. However, in researching the history of 2003, I identified three events occurring during the spring of that year that make strong statements to you, the class of 2021, strong statements about who you must be. First stop on our journey, April 16th, 2003. Look at that, huh? Somebody's birthday, right? Let me, by show of hands, class of 2023, raise your hand if you know who Michael Jordan is. Yeah, everybody does, right? It may seem like a strange question, but the reality is that not one of you from the class of 2021 saw him play a live basketball game. How do I know this? Because on April 16th, 2003, Michael Jordan retired from the NBA. But over your lives, you have heard his name, worn his shoes. I think my young man in the back even has the shoes and represent. There you go, I see you. You've heard his name, you've worn his shoes, you've seen his highlights, and you possibly argued his greatness versus LeBron or Kobe or KD or whoever. Point number one, what is history telling you you must be? History is telling you that you must be someone who makes a significant impact such that what you do will be remembered long after you stop doing it. Class of 2021, what you do matters. So do something significant with your lives. Go forth from this space and leave your mark on society. Commit yourselves to positively impacting every life, every space, and every place that you find yourself in. Be an influencer. Not like the type we see on TikTok, but the type of influencer that understands that you are at your best when you are making others better. Let me say this again. Be an influencer that recognizes that you are at your best when you are making others better. Jumping back in our time travel machine. Let's travel a bit further into 2003, and we're gonna arrive at April 28th. On this day in 2003, Apple released iTunes. iTunes was a game changer for the digital music industry. And although it wasn't initially received well by everyone in the music industry, by 2010, when you were in the fifth grade, iTunes was the largest music retailer on the planet. Apple iTunes was not a game changer because it was creative. It was a game changer because it was innovative. Point two, what is history telling you you must be? History is telling you that you must be innovative, a game changer. Innovation is not just doing something new, but it's doing something new that adds value because it's more efficient and creates an advantage that makes life better for other folks. Innovation is not creating a different tasting hamburger. Innovation is creating a plant-based impossible burger. Our world needs you, the class of 2021, to create impossible burgers. Actually, that's a metaphor, not really creating burgers. We need you to be the catalyst that causes us to think differently about solving the problems we currently face and those that we see on the horizon. We need you to be innovators. Shout out to Westside Innovative Schoolhouse founding parents, Suzanne Goldstein, Jenny Brooke, Stephanie Schulenberger, and Wendy Ackerman. Show them some love. Innovation. However, I warn you that although the rewards of innovation are great, innovation is a messy job. You will fail, and you will fall, and you will not get everything right. Innovation will cost you time, and effort, and blood, and sweat, and tears in your quest to ultimately change our world for the better. But history is telling you that you must be innovative. Our final stop in our travel journey is May 30th, 2003. This is the release date for Finding Nemo. In case you didn't know, Finding Nemo is one of my favorite Pixar films, second only to Toy Story 1, also amazing. However, Finding Nemo tells the story of an overprotective clownfish dad named Marlin, parents I can identify with this guy, who along with a blue tang named Dory searches for his missing son Nemo. Along the way, Marlin develops the courage to take risks and comes to terms with Nemo taking care of himself as they both overcome physical and mental and emotional challenges. Point three, my last point. What is history telling you? History is telling you that you must be courageous. In the face of all life's challenges, despite physical, mental, and emotional trials, despite life's setbacks, and you will have them, despite others' unwillingness or inability to see your gifts and talents, yes, haters are real, despite racism, or sexism, or classism, or ableism, or any other ism out there, you must have the courage to live your life with purpose and on purpose. Courage does not mean that you won't be sad and disappointed at times, nor does courage mean that you won't be afraid. However, being courageous is the ability to move forward and accomplish your goals despite the sadness, despite the disappointment, despite the misunderstanding, and despite the fear. So, Wish Academy graduating class of 2021, look around you. The whole team is here. Listen carefully. History is speaking to you and is telling you what you must be. You must be young people, young adults who make significant impacts on the world around you. You must be innovative as you engage your peers and colleagues to solve community, national, and global problems. And you must be courageous and committed to living with purpose and on purpose in service of others. Class of 2021, you are the first link of the chain that will become Wish Academy's legacy of greatness. Our hope is for you to individually and collectively achieve a level of greatness that your forebears only dreamed of. We love you. We are proud of you. And yes, our expectations for you are very high. But today, June 10th, 2021, we celebrate you and all that you have accomplished. Congratulations and God bless you.
To come onto the stage and receive your diploma from Miss Kelly Mole.
Noah Shen. Max Mendelson. Robert Mercari. Beckett Cater. Malik Castro De Verona. John Broyle. Stefan Baum Harvey. Marco Barone. Leilani Bankston Carruthers. Sydney Abad. Savi Bindas. Kiara Crawford Harper. Sahib Chopra. Landon Dawson. Ismail Dominguez. Juliana Dunn. Devin Early. Timbiti Ermias. Dylan Gallardo. Kai Gentry. Fabian Gonzalez.
Michael Pekacek. Kaylin Grigsby. Stacy Gutierrez. Elise Guzman. Abel Helamesco. Hunter Hibbard. McCole Howard. Baby Jackson. Kalia Jackson Presley. Paola Lauterbach Barba. Dylan Knight. Christian Jones Logan. Corey Johnson. Edgar Lemus. Nathan Lopez. Yesenia Luna Lara. Zachariah Lynch. Ryan Lucas. Justin Paxton. Nathan Otazu. Dayla Nella. Luis Monroy. Dwayne Sutherland Jr. Nerjan Martin. Stacy Martinez. Gustav Miller. Alex Monroy.
Dylan Richardson. Omarion Randolph Presley. Ashley Vianne Rosales Torres. Sheetobom Nwabazor. Jimena Sanchez. Joshua Sims. Shivay Singh. Jenna Stamm. Jack Steinberg. Omar Perez. Daniel Peterson. Imari Taylor. Kennedy Van Skyver.
Tina Vicarell. Madison Willis.
I'm not sure if that was Kennedy's dad. I'm unsure if that was him. Class of 2021. Congratulations, you are the first graduating class of Wish Academy. Scholars, you may consider yourselves high school graduates of the year of 2021. Please now move your tassels from the right to the left. Now stand, and on the count of three, you may throw your graduation caps. Please stand, class of 2021.